Hey everybody, what's going on? And welcome to another installment of the Punisher Retrospective. Now on the Retrospective today, we're going to be talking about one of my favorite Punisher things ever, the Punisher arcade game. After taking the fight to the mob, the Punisher and or optionally Nick Fury discovers that the Kingpin is the big baddie. It is up to them to put a stop to his criminal empire. First things first, this game comes from Capcom, and in this era of beat-em-ups, they were king. Capcom is known for the Final Fight series, the D&D series, Knights of the Round, and the lesser known but amazing Warriors of Fate, just to name a few. The Punisher arcade game offered one or two player action. You could either be the Punisher, Nick Fury, or you could team up and be both. Now if you play this game, you realize that both players pretty much play the same, but in a solo game, they have different dialogue and interactions with certain villains. For example, whereas Nick Fury will just kick Scully here out of the bus, old Frank will just up and shoot him. There are examples of this all throughout the game. When it comes to the gameplay, again, this is the era where Capcom ruled this genre. Now granted, this game is mostly the standard beat-em-up, but there's also parts of the game where anytime bad guys with guns come on screen, our violent anti-hero pulls out a pistol and goes to town with unlimited ammo. A bit of a tip for you if you're going to be playing this game, the unlimited ammo is very helpful against bosses if you can keep one of the bad guys with guns on screen long enough. I know what you're thinking, this is the Punisher, he should be having guns pretty much the entire time, and if you feel that not having guns the whole time kinda sucks, well, don't worry, you're gonna get plenty of weapons in this game, and yes, that does include guns to dispatch the bad guys. As a fan of the Punisher, there is nothing like blowing away a bad guy with an M16, and he's got nothing. Well, yes, again, this is kind of a standard beat-em-up, there is a small, simple story that actually makes things work. The story is told by short cutscenes between levels, sort of like the Alien vs. Predator arcade game, which actually came out a year later than this one in 1994. I have to say that the Punisher arcade game and the AVP arcade game are very similar, but of course that's going to happen, they're both made by Capcom. When it comes to enemies, you get the usual beat-em-up fare. There's generic baddies with palette swaps, and honestly this is the norm for most beat-em-up games. As a nice little twist to the Punisher, I do have to say that the criminals at the beginning of the game is the same mob family that killed Frank Castle's family, the Costas. Some of the street fodder even share names from the real comic book villains that gunned down his family. I have to say that knowing that information makes playing this game just a little more satisfying. When it comes to the bosses, I would say that Punisher fans will probably know most of them. The main villains consist of Scully, Bushwhacker, Bonebreaker, the Dr. Doom provided guard droids, there's two of them, and of course, the Kingpin. When it comes to the known villains, I think Jigsaw got it worst. He is forced to be an easily defeated mini-boss on one of the ever Capcom popular beat-em-up elevator stages. Now you're probably asking yourself, did this game make it to home consoles? Well, unfortunately, yes. Yes, it did. Now, there are too many reasons to get into why you should just find and play the arcade version, so let's just say that overall, the Genesis version flat out sucks. Lastly, there is one cool, small little thing I like about this game. After you beat the game, you get an actual kill count for the many enemies that you punish throughout the entire game. Look, I'm sure you can tell by now, if you love beat-em-ups and you love the Punisher, you should definitely play this game. Since there's probably not an arcade around you that has it, or actually there's probably not an arcade even around you, you should seek out a MAME emulator and check it out. I never got to play this game in the arcade, so my first experience was on a MAME emulator, and I have to say that every time I play it, I love it. Again, if you're a fan of the Punisher or you're just a fan of beat-em-up games, you will enjoy this game. As always, thank you so much for watching. What did you think of the Punisher arcade game? Feel free to comment on down in the section below. But remember, it's not vengeance, it's punishment. I'm Gino Reynolds from The Real Gino. Till next time.